Greetings. If you are Muslim, I invite you, and even challenge you, to listen to this entire video. Let's continue examining the next claim of Deedat's combat kit. In fact, this next point is in one version of Deedat's combat kit that I found, but not in the second one I have found. Point 7. Baca is Mecca, the holy Kaaba built by the Prophet Abraham, peace be upon him, and his son Ishmael, peace be upon him, is in Mecca. The name Mecca, Mecca, is mentioned in the Quran, Surah 48:24, and he it is who held back their hands from you and your hands from them in the valley of Mecca, after he had given you victory over them, and Allah is seeing what you do. So it appears Mr. Deedat is actually able to search for a word and find a correct reference to it. But then the author attempts to create an imaginary link to somewhere in the Bible. Another name for Mecca is Baca, depending on the dialect of the tribe. This is also mentioned once in Surah 396. Surah 396, surely the first house of worship is a translator insertion, established for humanity is the one at Baca, a blessed sanctuary and a guide for all, again a translator insertion, people. I don't want to make any false accusations, but notice the following observation. The name Mecca, Mecca, from Surah 48:24, Valley of Mecca. Evidently spelling is meaningless to words in Arabic. You will find at least three different spellings in translations. Mecca, Mecca, and Mecca. But it gets worse. Another name for Mecca is Baca, depending on the dialect of the tribe. This is also mentioned once in Surah 396. So there are at least four different spellings in various versions of the Quran. Mecca, Mecca, and Mecca, and Baca. Once you accept that confusion, you readily accept Baca could also be any word that sounds similar. Baca, 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 blah, blah, blah. Unfortunately, Muslims are desperate to create credentials for Muhammad, to defend and attempt to give legitimacy to Mo's religion, Islam. I honestly have no interest with the Quran's confused, self-contradicting foolishness. It is a false religion, so I do not care if they worship in Mecca, Baca, or Kaaba. The issue comes when they lie about the Bible to steal credentials for their false, hellish, idolatrous religion. Surah 396, surely the first house established for humanity is the one at Baca, a blessed sanctuary and a guide for all people. Again, Mo's lust for first makes him claim the first house from Allah was Mecca, not the temple in Jerusalem. This contradiction of all prophets were Muslims, therefore the temple in Jerusalem was the first, is literally beyond the mind and grasp of everyone retarded by Islam. O you who believe, ask not questions about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble. Surely the first house established for humanity is the one at Baca, Mecca, Kaaba, a blessed sanctuary and a guide for all people. A reasonable person, reading the so-called clear Quran, might assume this refers to a noted holy building. Those who worship Mo's words would consider this building holy and visit this building. Remember that. This claim is attempting to make Baca in the Bible a reference to the city where the first house of Allah of Islam is. Surely the first house of worship established for humanity. To those who submit to Muhammad in Islam, this must mean the Kaaba at Mecca, Saudi Arabia, and no place else. And if some place in the Bible referred to Mecca, Saudi Arabia, that would be a feather in the cap of Islam. That is the whole hope of this jihad, this oh so weak claim that Baca, Israel, is Baca, is Mecca, is Mecca. So what is the most obvious way to prove this claim is false? Demonstrate that the mention of Baca in the Bible is of a real place in Israel called Baca. Here's a partial map of Israel from ancient times. Let me expand this part for you. Do you see this town named Baca? So there was a town named Baca in Israel. But intellectual honesty and rigor requires me to judge this as weak evidence. After several searches with Google and other search engines, this is the primary map I found, and I cannot find its source. So little is made of Baca that some sites even write of it as a metaphor and not necessarily a village or town worthy of note. I think a more rigorous proof and refutation of this Islamic falsehood is to analyze the context and usage. Psalm 84 verse 1. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Jehovah, Lord of hosts! My soul longs, even faints, for the courts of Jehovah, the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. The courts of the Lord refer to the temple courts, meaning in Jerusalem. Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she places her young, near your altars, O Jehovah, Lord of hosts, my King and my God. The altars again refer to the temple, meaning in Jerusalem. So if you are Muslim, are you noticing Prophet David never, ever uses the word Allah? Does Muhammad ever call this Allah his king? Think about that. As we soon discover, David is talking of going to Jerusalem via the Valley of Baca. How blessed are those who dwell in your house. They are ever praising you, Selah, God's house, Jehovah's temple, in Jerusalem. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, whose hearts are set on pilgrimage. Oh, Muslim, do not think the word pilgrimage is owned by Mohammedism. Christian pilgrims to Jehovah God's holy city of Jerusalem predate Mohammedism and Islam by 600 years. And Jewish pilgrims to Jerusalem for 1500 years before that. As they pass through the Valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. Even the autumn rain covers it with pools. The Jewish going to Jerusalem pass through the Valley of Baca. Surely the first house of worship established for humanity is the one at Baca, a blessed sanctuary. According to Muhammad's Quran, the house of worship is in Baca, Mecca, Shakalaka, Ding Dong. So if the Quran is self-consistent on this point, this confirms its usage of Baca does refer to Mecca. As they pass through the Valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. Even the autumn rain covers it with pools. But according to Prophet David, this Baca, the Baca he mentions, is not the place of the temple of Jehovah God, the house of Jehovah God. Clearly, the Valley of Baca is nothing more than a part of the trip to Jerusalem, where the house of God actually resides. So ignore the deceptive twisting and torturing of Mecca, Mecca, Makkah, Baca, Becca, Baca, Kaka, Shakalaka, Ding Dong, yada yada yada. In Muhammad's Quran, Baca, Mecca, Shakalaka, Ding Dong is the destination. In Jehovah God's Holy Bible, the Valley of Baca is just one leg of the journey to the city of God. They go from strength to strength until each appears before God in Zion. O Jehovah, Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob, Selah, in Zion. Again, the pilgrimage by Jews is to Jerusalem, in Zion, Israel, not pagan Arabia. Prophet David wrote this more than 1,000 years before Muhammad was a blood clot formed from his father's seed. When Saudi Arabia was totally pagan, worshipping 360 different deities, including one named Allah. Take notice of our shield, O God, and look with favor on the face of your anointed. For better is one day in your courts than 1,000 elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. The house of my God is in Jerusalem. The courts of the temple of Jehovah God is in Jerusalem, Zion. For Jehovah, the Lord God, is a sun and a shield. Jehovah, the Lord, gives grace and glory. He withholds no good thing from those who walk with integrity or uprightly. O Jehovah, Lord of hosts, how blessed is the man who trusts in you. Do you really think Mecca, Saudi Arabia, is on the way to Jerusalem, Israel, the holy city of God, in Zion? It's not clear if this Baca is Mecca gambit and fraud is in Deedat's original combat kit or not. It does not matter, because the idea is rubbish, like the rest of Deedat's desperate combat kit. Do you really think Almighty God, your Creator, needs desperate lies to convince you to follow Him? If you are Muslim, do you think a pamphlet of lies, like the combat kit, can ever lead you to the truth? Listen to the questions in your heart and your mind, telling you Islam is false. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.